I'm gonna bring somebody up here and y'all gonna say, I thought she had on a green dress. How she do that? I know y'all been looking, be like, I thought she had it, now she got on a... But they doubled. Derrick McCray, for all that you do, and I say the same thing that I said about Sheila Ross, I do believe that the Holy Spirit empowers you to do what you do. Nobody ain't had to tell me, because I've had passenger seat to the things that you do. Thank you. Thank you. If no one else ever says it, thank you on behalf of Children's Oasis, its board members, the people who we represent, and the people that are within our organization. God bless you, and we present you with our Children's Oasis Man of the Year. You know what's important to point out that God just dropped into my spirit to share with each and every one of you? That Superman don't wear a cape. Superman don't wear a cape. Wonder Woman don't wear them little tight drawers and run around saying the word. Superman and Wonder Woman is inside each and every one of us. I can do all things through Christ that gives me strength. Now, because I know my friend, we friends, because I know my friend, and I'm going to give him the microphone. I'm going to stand beside him. Because when my friend ready to go, he could go. So I'm just going to stand right beside him here and just kind of give him a little nudge. When he...
He don't have to do that. But listen, first of all, I want to thank God. And I want to thank God for blessing me too. Great parents, because anything that I do is a testament of them, their integrity, their love for the community, and how well they fought. But my giving and what I do comes from me hitting rock bottom. So I understand what it's like to be on the other side too, you know. And a lot of the things that people have said about you, but it's me trusting in God first.
Amen.
He said, I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. When I'm weak, I'm strong. You know, and I've been at some low points in my life. You know, but I always see the bigger picture. You know, I've never been a guy to see the glass half empty. I always see it half full. Mr. Callaway and those guys know that I was the smallest man on the football team. And I always believed I could get an end zone. I always believed that I could do the impossible, because God said if he's with me, who could be against me?
Amen.
And that he prepares a table in the presence of my enemies, that my cup shall run over.
Yeah.
And I believe that. I don't question about faith. He said you need to have a mustard seed of faith to move a mountain. But I just dive in the ocean of faith and just keep swimming. And don't even worry about it, because I know that he got a cattle on a thousand hills. So it don't matter what the task is or how big it is, that if he's for you, you can get it done. Sometimes it might be fast, but sometimes it might be slow, because that's where the endurance comes in. He said that the race ain't given to the swift or the strong, but to the man that endures. So it's about endurance. It's about keeping focused. It's about keep going. When the road looks tough, you got to keep going. When it looks like it's nothing, you got to keep going. You know, and that's the blessing of God. And that's how I look at it. I'm not perfect. I ain't never been perfect. And I've seen him use David, I've seen him use Solomon, I've seen him use Samson, I've seen him use Paul, I've seen him use a whole lot of us that are imperfect. Yeah. But the only perfect one is Jesus Christ. Yeah. See, and we look toward that high calling, which is in him, that we strive for perfection.
Yeah.
So we're never perfect, but we strive for it. So we're always trying to do the best that we can do to help our people. And God say, love your brother as you love yourself.
Yeah.
So if I love me, that means I need to love my brother. I need to feed my brother. I need to take care of him. It ain't about Derrick McCray. It's about God first. It's about the community. It's about my family, then my community. Then I sit somewhere 6 or 7 calls, then my staff, and then everybody come before me. But with Jason can tell you that he went all the way from playing here at Spanish River to go play for the Carolina Panthers. See, that's how far he went. When I met Jason and one of my sons were very good friends. And he was leaving the camp and he couldn't take care of himself. And his mom was struggling to make sure that he was straight. And he couldn't pass the test, was giving him a hard time. So I said, Jason, we gotta do something about this because his coaches didn't want to help him. I'm like, how are you not gonna help this tremendous athlete? That's me in school for education. He in school just for athletics. So I stuck in and just Eric the father, and we had to go somewhere to rock. You know what? He went on to star as a star athlete at the University of Louisiana Lafayette. And from there, he got picked up by the Carolina Panthers and played. And on that score, the touchdown against the New York Giants. He'll tell you, he ran the 90-yard touchdown. Football league. And that's based on him having the great spirit, but not only that, but our job is to help people and to do what we can to help each other. And my job is now for, again, and I don't want to say it's the wrong way, but black folks, we got to speak together. We got to do things together. We got to trust each other. We got to love each other. We got to treat each other with respect. We got to do business with each other also. Because we done been through some horrific stuff. And I often tell people, look at the neighborhoods that we came through a severe drug epidemic. We came through the AIDS crisis. We came through a lot of stuff. There's no discipline in the schools no more. So we got a lot to deal with. And we need to be conscious about what's going on. And we can't blame everybody for what's going on with us. And you know, everybody talking about, the fruit is bad, but what about the tree? The tree had to produce the fruit. So we need to take a better look at how we're starting to parent and just doing different things to raise our kids so we can have a better generation. We done lost about 4 generations due to drugs, crime. Now we got black on black crime. This is horrible. It has to stop. And we got to do something about it. And that's our goal. And I also want to give a shout out to the city of Palm Beach Gardens for being here. They've been remarkable with how they've handled the Corey Jones situation. They've been very forthcoming and transparent. You know, they've done a good job, you know, and I have to give a lot of blessings to Ray Whiteley and what he's doing with the children's Oasis in the National. He's a born leader, and he's the true spokesman of this movement. We started Black Vote Matters because without black votes, we don't do anything. Black lives don't matter unless black votes matter. Because we got to get the right people in office that's going to take care of our issues. And so it's important that we have platforms, that we look at platforms that's going to strengthen the education in our community. It's going to lessen the crime. It's going to help the redevelopment and different things that's going on that we need. So it's very important that we come together and that we love God first. With all our heart, we love God first. And then we move forward. But I'm very thankful, I'm humble. I'm grateful for all the friends and family. It's Callaway, my goddaddy, Sammy B. McDonald, my brother and nieces and friends that have come, Zach and Vader, that play football. They're my rapper brothers. Y'all stand up.
I know you talk about Alabama.
Okay,
you
brother.
You got Florida.
I'm very thankful, and I love you. Let's put our hands together for Derrick, McCray. We're almost out your way. There are some young ladies that